In this illustration, we'll analyze a proton splitting a deuteron. Here we are given that when a proton of mass MP is fired on a deuteron of mass MD having binding energy EB, it splits into its constituents, so we are required to find the minimum kinetic energy of proton required for this reaction. We can also take the mass of proton and neutron to be equal. Here in the solution, here we can see if a proton having a mass MP is fired on a deuteron, which is having a mass MD. And in this collision, when the proton is approaching with the speed Vp, we can see the maximum possible loss in kinetic energy of proton will take place when the two particles, colliding particles, will move together. So, after collision, if this is the state, before collision and after collision, say these two particles of mass MP plus MD, both of these move together with the final velocity Vf. If this is the state after collision, then we can say this is the case of perfectly inelastic collision in which maximum energy loss will take place. And we can say after collision, if this deuteron will transform to D star, where we consider D star as the excited deuteron. So here we can see when proton reacts with D, it transforms D to D star. Here this was at rest, this was moving with some initial kinetic energy, that is half MP Vp square. And finally, these two are moving together with the final kinetic energy. We can write half MP plus MD multiplied by V final square. And we can write by conservation of momentum. Here we can write MP Vp was the initial momentum of this proton, that should be equal to the final momentum, which is MP plus MD multiplied by V final, which gives us the value of final speed with which the two particles are moving. That is equals to MP Vp divided by MP plus MD. Now, in this situation, the maximum loss in kinetic energy which takes place here, if it is absorbed by deuteron, where this D star can be written as excited deuteron nucleus, and if the absorbed energy is EB, then this D star will split into its constituents. So here we can write if D star is the excited nucleus with the absorbed energy EB. This implies we can write initial kinetic energy minus EB should be equal to the final kinetic energy of the particles in collision. So in this situation here, we can substitute the values like here KI we can write as half MP Vp square minus EB is equals to final kinetic energy is half MP plus MD multiplied by V final square, which is MP Vp upon MP plus MD whole square. Here if we rearrange these terms, we can see rearranging the terms here, we are getting the value of this can be written as initial kinetic energy. So this initial kinetic energy can be written as KI. From here also I can take half MP Vp square common. So this will be KI multiplied by 1 minus MP over MP plus MD is equals to EB. And further simplifying, we'll get the value of initial kinetic energy for this reaction to take place, in which D will absorb EB amount of energy so that it will further split into its constituents. And the minimum value of this KI can be given as this MP plus MD divided by MD multiplied by EB. this will be the result of this problem. So, this or more than this, any kinetic energy when proton is fired onto a deuteron, during reaction, it can absorb energy more than or equals to Eb. So, it will split into its constituents.